Now for the next problem naman, meron akong pinost dito kahapon, but the problem was symmetrical. Medyo madali yan. This is a bit difficult kasi ano kasi to? This is unsymmetrical kasi. Yan. So, paano yan sagutan? Ito yung approach. Yung weight ng cylinder, cylinder C saka D, yan yung tension dito sa hinge at A, yan din yung tension sa hinge at B. So, basahin natin yung problem. We have cylinder C and D, and then attached sila sa end ng cables. So, yung mass per unit length ng cable is 50 kilograms per meter. If cylinder D has a mass of 600 kilograms, determine the required mass of cylinder C in kg. Now, in this problem, you don't have to convert kg into newtons. Bakit? Yung binigay kasi in kilograms, and then yung nasa question kasi is in kg kasi. So, don't convert that to newtons na. So, mangyayari dito is, dito sa B, we have a reaction of, this is, diba, 600 kN man yung weight ng D. So, 600 yung tension dito. Yan. So, meron yan siyang inclination na, sabihin natin, since this is at point B, sabihin natin beta. Yan. And then, dito naman sa A, yan, we also have another tensile force, but hindi pa natin yan alam, sabihin natin TA, T sub A. So, meron din yan siyang angle of inclination, which is, since nasa point A tayo, lagyan natin ng alpha. Yan. So, for the first step, we can consider the total system to identify kung ano yung value ng beta. Now, paano yan, sir? We can sum up moments about A to eliminate this tensile force. Kasi yan, dalawang unknowns kasi dito. Yan. So, we can sum up moments about A, set natin to 0. So, we have 600 kilograms. Yan, meron yan siyang vertical component and horizontal component. Bala, magiging ganito. Yan. So, yung vertical component niya, moment arm is 12 meters going to A. And then, it causes a counterclockwise rotation. So, minus 600 pala multiplied by i-component muna natin, bala, sine beta, and then multiply natin by 12. Yan. And then, for the horizontal component naman, it will cause a clockwise rotation about A with a moment arm of 3 meters. Yan, 3. So, plus pala, 600 cosine beta, and then multiplied by 3. Yan. And then we have the weight of itong entire system. Diba, meron yan siyang weight na 50 kilograms per meter. Yan. So bala, diba, meron yan siyang resultant sa gitna, which is 50 multiplied by 12. Yan. And then, this is acting sa center. So, yung distance pala niya is, yung moment arm is 6 meters pala. Yan. So, we have here plus 50 times 12. Bala, pwede mo lang 12 squared over 2. Para lang tong 50 times 12 multiplied by 6. The same lang yan. But, mas maganda kasi to pag, ano mo, nakabisa mo. Kasi, lahat ng moments, pwede mong gawing wx squared over 2 if meron kang uniform load over the whole span. Ito yung moment sa isang point kung ano, simply supported. Yan. So, set down natin to 0. And then, solve natin si beta. So, minus 600 sine beta times 12, and then plus 600 cosine beta multiplied by 3, and then plus 50 times 12 squared over 2. So, set natin to 0. Wait lang. Yung naset ko kasing angle is negative. Gawin natin positive, let's say 45. Kasi ito yung gitna ng 0 at 90. Ito yung pinaka-safe. Wait lang. Tama ba? Plus, then minus. So, beta pala is, ano yan, 43.05 degrees, yan. So, sulat na lang din natin dito. Yan, but, para maka-checking tayo later, isi-store na lang natin yung value. So, shift, store, lagay natin sa B, kasi beta. Yan. So, 43.05, nandyan sa B. And then, for the second step, we can now make a cut dito sa section natin. So, ano na lang, remove ko na lang to. I will screenshot kasi. So, andito yung lowest point. Ah, dito pala. Yan. And then, let's also make another screenshot para sa other side. So, andito rin. Yan. So, nakat na natin. Diba, meron yan siyang FH dito. And then also for the other side. Now, nakamili ako sa cut, but essentially we are considering the right side cutting at the lowest point. Dito tayo magka-cut. Yan. So this is also FH. So meron yan siyang weight na kinikarry dyan. 50 kilograms per meter. And then, sa kabila din. Yan. So, for the next step, diba, alam ko yung beta. So, masasolve ko pala yung FH. Kasi, if I will, anong tawag dito? If I will sum up forces along the horizontal, makukuha ko yung FH. So, summation daw tayo. Summation tayo ng forces along X. Diba, opposite yung direction ng FH saka ito. So, pwede natin i-equate. So, FH is, ano pala? 600 cosine of beta. Yan. So, lagay natin. 600 cos recall B. We have 438.43. Yan. And then this is kilograms. Now, isustore na lang din natin to sa saan ba? Dito na lang sa letter C. Yan. Lagay na lang natin. naka-store yan sa C. Ito naman sa B. So, nakuha na natin yung FH. Ano yung next nating makukuha? We can also get the distance, the horizontal distance sa cut na to. So, di ba yung buong distance is 12 meters. Now, what if ililabel ko to as X? Yan. Lagay daw natin. Sabihin natin X. So, mangyayari sa kabilang side, this distance naman, huwag mong pansinin yung 12. Yan. Di ba 12 yung total? So, this is 12 minus X. Yan. So, masasolve na natin yung X. We can do that by summing up forces vertical. So, summation of forces along Y. Diba, meron tayong 600 kilograms and then sine of beta. Yan. And then, minus 50, this distributed load, multiply natin by the distance, 12 minus X, para makuha natin yung resultant. So, set natin to 0. So, we have here 600 sine beta and then minus 50 times 12 minus X. So, set to 0. We have 3.807. Now, isa-store lang din natin yan sa another variable naman. Sabihin natin sa letter D. So, shift store D. Yan. So, nasa D na yan. And then, ano ba yung questions dito? For the first question, what is the required mass of cylinder? Of the cylinder. So, hindi pa natin yan nahanap. Kasi itong 438.43, yan kasi yung FH. So, wala pa. Determine the horizontal distance from point B to the lowest point in meters. Now, this is point B. So, yung tanong sa number 3 is this distance. Yan. But yung nakuha natin kanina is ito pa. Ano yun? Diba? 3.807. So, ano yung remaining distance pala? Diba? We can just subtract X sa 12. So, 12 minus X. Recall. Saan nga yan? D. So, our answer is 8.19. Now, store ko na lang din yan sa E. Yan. So, color na lang natin yan. Nakalagay yan sa E. So, 8.19. Dito na lang. 8.19 meters, which comes from 12 minus ano yan? 3.807. Lagay na lang din natin. X equals 'yan. So for number 3 pala, ito yung sagot natin, 8.19. So, yung trap na choice dito is itong letter A. So, be careful dyan. Now, for the next problem, I mean, ano yung next question dito na masasagutan? Meron tayong FH. So, we can answer number 1 na. So, paano ba? For number 1, we can consider this cut. Yan, so, move natin on to, diba alam natin yung FH is 438.43. Now, alam naman din natin yung X din. Alam natin yung X. This is 3.807 meters. So, yan. But again, nakastore yan sa letter D. Yan. So, to solve TA pala, yan, we have, anong gagawin natin? Diba, TA is, ito lang yung resultant ng FH, saka yung total load natin acting downward. So, mangyayari is, TA pala is square root of FH squared plus the weight, uniform load, multiply natin by the distance X. So, bala, W times X squared. So, we have square root of, saan yan nakastore? Diba, nakastore to sa C. So, C pala yan, C squared. And then, plus, W natin is 50. Yan, X natin is nakastore sa D. So, 50 times D. And then squared. Yan. So, input natin. We have square root of C squared plus 50 times D. Squared din natin. So, we have 477.986. Yan. And then this is kilograms din. So, box natin kasi sagot yan. Saka ito rin. Yan. So, 477.98. Bala, sagot pala natin is letter A. Yan. And then, for the maximum sag H, we can still consider the same cut and then magsasum up tayo ng moments about A. So, summation of moments about A. We have FH. It will cause a counterclockwise reaction. Yan. And then multiply natin by this distance. Yan. Diba? This is H. So, minus FH pala, multiplied by H, and then, plus 50, yung distance na yan, multiply natin by X, and then its moment arm is half of X. So, bala, ano pala? 50 times X times X over 2. So, set natin to 0. So, we have minus FH. Again, FH nakastore sa C. So, negative C times H. Yan yung unknown natin. And then, plus 50 times yung X nakastore sa D. So, recall D. Square na lang natin kasi X times X magiging square lang yan. And then, divide by 2. So, equal 0. X pala, or height pala is 0.826. Yan. So we have ano pala? Letter D. Yan yung maximum sag of the cable. Yan. 0.083. Now, for checking, ito yung pwede natin gawin. We can first get angle alpha. Now, angle alpha is diba, tangent theta equals y over x. Yung force along y over the horizontal force. Now, yung force along y is 50 times X. And then the force along X is this value. which is nakastore sa C. Yan na lang. So, gagawin din ko yung D. So, kunin natin yung angle, di ba, arctan of 50 times D divided by C. So, 23.47. Na store ko yan sa E. I mean, alpha pala yan. Gawin na lang din natin alpha. I mean, wala pa. Sa A na lang. Shift store A. Kasi alpha. So, for checking, we can sum up forces vertical for the total system. Now, we have, diba, TA. San yung TA? This is TA. Na-store ko ba yan? Nako, wala. I-store na lang natin yan sa E. For a while, ah. Square root of C squared plus 50 times D squared. Yan. So, shift store E. So, summing up forces vertical for the total system, we have parang TA ano yan, sine alpha plus this one bala 600 sine beta and then minus 50 yung buo na 50 multiplied by 12. This must be equal to 0. Yan yung checking natin. So, again, recall E. Yan yung tension at A. And then sine alpha plus 600 sine beta minus 50 times 12. Yan. So, set down natin to 0 na. So, tama yung sagot natin. So, lagay ko na lang. This is for checking. Yan. Tama na to. 478. Yung mass. Height is 0.827. But wala pa tayong length ng cable. So, yan yung isusolve natin ngayon. So, again, for the length of the cable, we have this formula. S equals integral from 0 to x, x1 na lang, and then square root of 1 plus 2kx squared. Then we have dx. Yan. And then again, k here is y over x squared. Yan. So for this problem, we have to split it into two kasi meron tayong boundary conditions for this and another one for this one naman. Yan. So, from 0 to x1, ano yung x1? We have 3.807. And then square root of 1 plus 2 times k, y over x squared. Y dito is h, diba? So, ano yan? This is 0.826. Yan. So, 0.826 pala, yan yung y. Divide natin by x, which is 3.807.
Nakay money.
Wala pa. So, 3.807 square natin. Then, multiplied by x. Yan. So square root of, I mean, integral from 0 to 3.807, then square root of 1 plus 2 times 0.826 divided by 3.807 squared. Multiplied by x. Then, don't forget na itong whole expression, yan yung isi-square natin. So, 3.923. Ito. But this is still for the first length. So, lagay ko na lang. 3.92. And then copy ko na lang siya. Then let's just change the limits saka yung values. So for the second one, 8.193 yung length. So change natin to. So ito rin magiging 8.193 rin. Then 0.826. Height would be 0.826 plus 3. So, 3.826. Yang buong height na yan. So, yan lang. Then 8.193. So 9.26. So add natin yung dalawa plus 3.92. We have 13.18. So, ito na yung sagot natin. Yan, 13.2.